Access for Everyone, breaking down digital barriers for people with disabilities. Topic 17, heading structure.
Think about how you navigate a website. Are you reading word for word, line by line? Or are you skimming, looking for the headings and the keywords?
Most of us are skimming. We rely on heading structure. And that's no different for people who use screen readers and other types of assistive technology.
Lisa Maria is blind and notes that the web pages that are most easily used by her are those that have good heading structure. For example, a level one heading and a level two heading.
Those are wonderful things to make happen in the code so that as a blind person, I can skim through the page and know what the different sections of the page are.
So let's look at what Lisa Maria is talking about.
Here's an example of what headings should look like on a web page. The main heading, Sample University, is a level one heading. The subheadings, Fall, the deadline is quickly approaching, and Your Future Awaits, are level two headings, and each of the subtopics, such as Take a Tour, News, Academic Calendar, and Homecoming, are level three headings. But beware, just because headings on a page look correct doesn't mean that they actually are.
David's example is from the accessible web page for our fictitious sample university. Let me show you the inaccessible demo page. As you can see, the subtopics Take a Tour, News, Academic Calendar, and Homecoming under Your Future Awaits appear to be in place and correct. But a screen reader will tell you otherwise. The programmatic heading structure is actually missing from these altogether. This means that a lot of screen reader users will find it very difficult to navigate to these topics at all, or even know they are there.
Hear it straight from Lisa Maria, as she describes how people incorrectly use the term heading and confuse the purpose of heading structure.
A lot of people use headings to make font bigger and look pretty, but they're not really using it because it's the beginning of a section and it's a title. They're using it just to make the font bigger.
So remember, focus on function, use headings, and make sure they're nested properly. This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR. Or email us at OCR@ED.gov.